Hi, this is Mathia Ford, and I'm coming to you live again today. And today I want to talk about the progression of symptoms with chronic kidney disease. So lots of people find out they have kidney disease and they're in a certain stage. So I want to talk to you a little bit about what that means and what you can expect to happen. So again, chronic kidney disease gets worse with time. It's chronic, it's over time, it's a progressive disease. You can slow down the effects of chronic kidney disease. You can slow down the progression of kidney disease, but you can't necessarily go back. It's like having diabetes. You can control diabetes. You can manage your condition, reduce your blood sugar, but you're always going to have diabetes. So, I want you to know, though, it's important to understand you can change the progression. You can change the effects of the symptoms. So it starts out talking about GFR. GFR is the number that you want to pay attention to, that your doctor is paying attention to determine what stage of kidney disease you're in. So there's a lot of factors. There's things like your race, your gender, your age, and amount of creatinine. There's a formula that they use when they take your blood to determine your GFR. And GFR is glomerular filtration rate. Sorry, that's my dog's barking. that's why they say GFR. So it's a fairly complicated equation. But a fairly high score is 100, is you have 100% healthy functioning kidney disease. And then as it goes down towards 50, that means your kidneys are only performing half of their normal function. So if your GFR is 30, that means they're only 30%. So you get a progression of symptoms as well. So normal stage one is normal or high GFR. 90 mils per minute, so that's 90%. Your kidneys are still functioning well. It's pretty undetectable. You then go to stage two, which is mild chronic kidney disease, and you get a GFR of 60 to 89 mils per minute. And so I'm loving this word. Glomerular filtration rate. I'm going to type that on the comments so you don't have to try to understand what I'm saying. Your kidneys, the small capillaries that I always talk about, you have these very small capillaries in your kidneys, and they kind of form little tubules. And so this is your urinary system and this is your blood vessel. And so the waste flow from your blood vessels into these basically waste accepting parts of your body. So as these are damaged, then you lower your ability to filter. That's the bottom line. Third stage is broken up into two parts, A and B, and GFR of 45 to 59 is stage A, and stage 3B is 30 to 44. So at stage 3, you're between 30 and 60% capacity of your kidneys. Moderate damage, this is where you start feeling symptoms. This is where you start getting doctors telling you that you need to make changes. You get fatigue, you might get some back pain, you might get some fluid retention. And then stage four is pretty severe chronic kidney disease. Your GFR is 15 to 29. Symptoms drastically affect your life. You're starting to get anemia. You're starting at nausea, vomiting. You're starting to feel some tingling in your extremities, loss of appetite, problems sleeping. You're just really your body's not managing well. And then stage five is less than 15 mils per minute, and that's called ESRD, end-stage renal disease, end-stage kidney disease. And it's where your kidney function needs to be started to be replaced with either a transplant or a dialysis machine. Several different kinds of dialysis. I'm going to talk about that on another live. But really, that's kind of where your symptoms happen and what is the progression. So when people say, what percentage kidney function do I have left? You can kind of look at your GFR and know, okay, I have this much function left. It's not a perfect system, but it's the one we have and it works pretty well. They're always reviewing and researching it. But for now, I think it's pretty good as far as if you want to know kind of what symptoms you're going to have. Your symptoms get pretty bad about stage four. You start feeling that nausea, tired, anemia, needing to do different things. And then stage five, you start feeling pretty tired and just your function, excuse me, your functioning goes down pretty significantly. And then people think dialysis is hard, but dialysis actually starts cleaning your blood again and you start feeling back to the normal stage three, stage two levels where you get your GFR numbers or your creatinine back out of your blood. So you actually feel a lot better on dialysis. So stage four, stage five is where you're really feeling bad. So thanks, Debbie. I appreciate it. And have a great day. Head on over to renaldiethq.com. Get your free meal plans and watch for tomorrow's live. Thanks.